Hello friends, today we are discussing about previous questions of research aptitude of UGC NET paper 1. First question, male and female students perform equally well in a numerical aptitude test. This statement indicates a statistical hypothesis, research hypothesis, null hypothesis, directional hypothesis. Answer C, null hypothesis. Second question, what is a research design? A way of conducting research that is not grounded in theory. The choice between using qualitative or quantitative methods. The style in which you present your research findings. Example, a graph. A framework for every stage of the collection and analysis of data. Answer D, a framework for every stage of the collection and analysis of data. The next one, sampling cases means sampling using a sampling frame, identifying people who are suitable for research, literally the researcher's briefcase, sampling of people, newspapers, television programs, etc. Answer D, sampling of people, newspapers, television programs, etc. Next one, the frequency distribution of a research data which is symmetrical in shape is similar to a normal distribution but center peak is much higher is skewed, mesocortic, leptocortic, platycutic. Then answer C, leptocortic. Then when planning to do a social research, it is better to approach the topic with an open mind. Do a pilot study before getting stuck into it. Be familiar with the literature on the topic. Forget about theory because this is very practical. Answer A, approach the topic with an open mind. The next one, when academicians are called to deliver lecture or presentation to an audience on certain topics or a set of topics of educational nature, it is called training program, seminar, workshop, symposium. Answer B, seminar. Next, in a thesis, figures and tables are included in the appendix, a separate chapter, the concluding chapter, the test itself. Answer D, the test itself. Next one, the research approach of Max Weber to understand how people create meaningful in natural setting is identified as positive paradigm, critical paradigm, natural paradigm. Answer D, interpretative paradigm. Next one, which one of the following is a non-probability sampling? Simple, random, purposive, systematic, stratified. Answer B, purposive. Next, identify the category of evaluation that assesses the learning progress to provide continuous feedback to the students during instruction, placement, diagnostic, formative, summative. Answer C, formative. The research stream of immediate application, conceptual research, action research, fundamental research, empirical research. Answer B, action research. Which is the main objective of research? To review the literature, to summarize what is already known, to get an academic degree, to discover new facts, or to make fresh interpretation of known fact. Answer D, to discover new fact or to make fresh interpretation of known fact. Sampling error decreases with the decrease in sample size, increase in sample size, process of randomization, process of analysis. Answer B, increase in sample size. The population informatics is called parameter while the corresponding sample information is known as universe, inference, sampling design, statistics. Answer D, statistics. In sampling, the lottery method is used for interpretation, theorization, conceptualization, randomization. Answer D, randomization. Which one of the following is not a type of experimental method? Single group experiment, residual group experiment, parallel group experiment, rational group experiment. Answer B, residual group experiment. Which one of the following is not a non-parametric test? T-test, sign-test, chi-square test, run-test. Answer A, T-test. Which one of the following techniques commonality is associated? Univariate analysis, factor analysis, case studies, SWOT analysis. Answer B, factor analysis. Identify the correct sequences. of research steps, selection of topic, review of literature, data collection, interpretation of findings, review of literature, selection of topic, data collection, interpretation of findings, selection of topic, data analysis, review of literature, interpretation of findings, selection of topic, review of literature, interpretation of findings, data collection. Answer A, selection of topic, review of literature, data collection, interpretation of findings. Which of one of the following is a non-probability sampling method? Answer, simple random sampling, stratified sampling, cluster sampling, quota sampling. Answer D, quota sampling. 21. A research paper is compilation of information on a topic, contains original research as deemed by the author, contains peer-reviewed original research or evaluation of research conducted by others, can be published in more than one journal. Answer C, contains peer-reviewed original research or evaluation of research conducted by others. Which one of the following belongs to the category of good research ethics? Publishing the same paper in two research journals without telling the editors, conducting a review of the literature that acknowledges the contribution of other people in the relevant field or relevant prior work, trimming outliers from a data set without discussing your reasons in a research paper, including a colleague as an author on a research paper in return for a favor even though the colleagues did not make a serious contribution to the paper. Answer B, conducting a review of literature that acknowledges the contribution of other people in the relevant field or relevant prior work. Then 23, which of the following sampling method is not based on probability? Simple random sampling, stratified sampling, quota sampling, cluster sampling. Answer C, quota sampling. Then 24, which one of the following references is written as per Modern Language Association, MLA format? Answer D, Hall Donald, Fundamentals of Electronics, New Delhi, Prentice Hall of India, 2005. Next one, a workshop is a conference for discussion on a topic, a meeting for discussion on a topic, a class at a college or university in which a teacher and the students discuss a topic, a brief intensive course for a small group emphasizing the development of a skill or technique for solving a specific problem. Answer D, a brief intensive course for a small group emphasizing the development of a skill or technique for solving a specific problem. Thank you for watching my channel. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and follow my Facebook page.